Hi everyone.
Hi.
So for today's class, we will be continuing on with our charcoal drawings. So all you will be needing today is a piece of charcoal, an eraser, and a pencil to sketch. And we will be continuing on with the drawing facial features from last week, and I will put a reference picture on right now. Everyone can take a picture of this reference picture.
Yeah.
And we will now begin. So first things first, I'm going to take my pencil and start on this sketch. So what I'm going to do first is draw a line down the center of my page. This is to help me make sure that my face is symmetrical. And then I'm going to mark the width of the mouth. So I am going to draw it quite big, just because the page, my paper is quite big, and it will be easier for us to capture all the details. So first, I'm just going to mark the two corners of the mouth, and using the center line to make sure that the two sides are symmetrical. So just two corners. Then what I'm going to do is draw a horizontal line across very lightly, because we are still in this sketch stage, and use this as the guideline for the center of the mouth. So now that I have the center of the mouth marked out, I'm going to start drawing in the opening of the mouth, starting with the lower lip. And I'm going to draw a small curved line right below the center line. or the lower lip. And then I'm going to draw the opening for the upper lip. So I'm going to mark a point about halfway to the corners and a little bit towards the left here. I'm going to draw a line slanting upwards and do the same with the other side. Like that. And then about also halfway to the center, I'm just going to flatten it out. Like that. So now we have the opening of the mouth. Now that we have this, I'm going to draw the actual lips. And if I use my pencil to help me measure the reference picture, I'll find that the lower lip is slightly bigger than the upper lip, and the upper lip is slightly bigger than the opening of the mouth. So knowing that, I'm going to mark in about the same length, same width as the opening for the lip. And bigger than that, the upper lip on the bottom. Then I'm just going to draw a little line out from these points, like, and we can kind of see the general shape of the lip now. So now that we have the bottom part and the top part of the lip marked, I'm going to start drawing in the actual shape of the lip. So if you notice the upper lip, you can see the lines on the lips curving upwards. So this can help us break down the lips a little. So from these two corners on the these two corners on the op opening of the mouth, we can draw a line curving upwards on both sides, like that. And then I'm going to draw another one going outwards, almost flat. Like that. And then breaking the width the lip into four parts, four equal parts. I'm going to place a dot on the top quarter and then draw a little triangle. At the top of the lip. And then I'm going to bring this shape down at a slant. I'm going to use my pencil to measure exactly how much it slants. So just hold your pencil to a distance away, at a distance from your reference picture. And then you can bring that down to your page. So I'll bring that down to the first curve. And then going to the second curve, it curves a little bit lower. Until finally, it goes all the way down, about halfway from the corner of the mouth to the end of the mouth. And I'm also going to add a little bit of curve down here. I'm also going to draw in a little bit of curve at the ends of the mouth, just because they're not actually harsh corners. And then now, moving on to the lower lip, I'm going to just darken these lines, and then at the center, give it a little bit of a dent here. And from there, we can bring down the crease at the center of the lip. And also give it a little bit of a curve at the bottom. And then we can bring it all the way to the end of the lip. So it kind of curves upwards and then a little bit outwards like that. So it curves up and then a little bit outwards. And then do the same with the other side. Just try to match it to the left side. Now that we have that marked out, we have pretty much the basic shape of the lips. And now I'm going to draw in the teeth. So on this particular person, they have a little bit of a gap between their teeth. So they do take up pretty much the entire opening of the mouth, like that. After that, I'm going to move upwards up to the nose. And we can see that there's a little dent here, right between the nose and the mouth, and it's roughly the same width, same height as the lips, the upper lips. So I'm going to draw that in. And then I'm adding a little bit of a curve up here to show where the nose begins. So, to find the width of the nose, we can use the mouth as a reference and see that it's roughly starts between the corners of the mouth and the outer corner of the mouth. So I'll use a line to roughly bring me up there and do the same for the other side. So that's about how wide the nose is. And then drawing a line right on top of here to show where the nose starts. Like that. And now, from up here, a little bit above this little dent, you can start drawing the nose curving out. And then down and then up and forming a nostril, and do the same for the other side. Like that. And then drawing the curves of the nose. And then up. So now we have the shape of the nose drawn. So the final thing I'm going to mark down with my sketch is the shadows. So I'm always going to draw in exactly where the light and the shadows meet, like here on the nose, as well as below the lips, separate the light from the dark. With whatever kind of lines that help, that can help you the most. Even if it's just changes in the shadow itself, it's good to have lines marking it. I will give everyone a second to complete this sketch, and then we will go on with the charcoal shading. Now I'm going to move on to the charcoal. So the first thing I'm going to fill in is the opening of the mouth. It's the darkest part on this drawing, so I definitely want to fill it in as dark as I can, so I have that darker value to compare to. So I will get started. Just be very careful not to shade over the lines. Since charcoal is harder to erase. And also, don't forget to grab a piece of tissue paper or toilet paper that you can use to smudge your drawing with. It can also be a useful tool to help pick up all of the charcoal that's breaking off of it. So now I'm just gonna slowly shade into the teeth. Make sure to leave the light parts. Light. And always use your eraser to erase all the little light details. And now I'm just shading in the ellipse, following the direction of the creases. And you can always use your eraser to slowly dab the drawing to lighten it instead of actually erasing everything. So I'm just slowly adding in layers and layers of charcoal to darken it. So on the right side of the lips, it's in the light, and all of the creases can be very clearly seen. So this part is going to be pretty tricky. First, I'm just going to draw in all of the creases, at least as much as I can. And then what I'm going to do is that I'm going to smooth it out with my paper. And then draw in these lines again using the eraser. And I'm just filling in some of the shadows around the mouth. It's important that we have shading outside of his mouth to show contrast. And then I'll smooth it out. With charcoal, it's much more beneficial to draw out the entirety of a picture than focusing on all the nitty-gritty details. So it's important that we get the big picture down instead of stressing over every single streak on our mouth here. So definitely pay more attention to all the value changes in the skin. Like how this part is just slightly brighter than this part, which is slightly brighter than this part, and which is slightly brighter than this part, which is the darkest part. So we definitely want to capture all of the subtle value differences on the face. I'll get in some skin details like this mole and this crease. At the end of the mouth. Just alternate between your paper and your charcoal. So now I'm just carefully adding in the details on the lips, the little streaks. So use the corners, the edges of your eraser to add in these little details. So now I'm just adding some subtle shading to the other side of the face, but make sure this side is much lighter compared to the side in the shadow. And I'm just fixing my line here, which is a little too harsh, just by lightly erasing it. Now I'm going to start shading on the nose. So I'm just going to leave my drawing here because there's always more detail that could be added. And we only have 3 minutes left of class. So if you're finishing up, that's great. And if you would like to show me your drawings, I would love to see them. And if you missed any parts, you can always look at the live stream on the YouTube channel. Ooh, Angela, that's very nice.
Thank you.
I like that a lot. Same with Jerry's. Those are they're all very nice. But one thing for Jerry is you can make the dark parts a little bit darker. That will just take it to the next level. Ooh, that looks very nice. Yes, those are all very great drawings.
I really like a painting.
Oh, you like painting?
Yeah, I really, really like
Oh, painting. Okay.
painting.
If
Drawing.
we can definitely move on to painting as our next
Yes.
medium, you would, if everyone would like that.
Future
Ooh,
is
the
about
Oh, so you took
2 weeks ago.
not the
Yeah.
old as we did, and that's added color. That's very nice. I really like that.
Thank you.
That's very nice. Very good work, everyone. We can definitely revisit our watercolor medium next. So good work, everyone.
Thank you, teacher.